So, as you may have heard, YouTube Gaming launched on August 26th, providing us with yet another alternative to the current heavyweight streaming champion, Twitch. However, a new streamer or somebody considering streaming may not know the difference between these two options. I know I had a bunch of questions myself, and so I'm making this quick video to outline the similarities, differences, pros, and cons of each service as of the date of this video. The first thing I want to look at is quality. YouTube Gaming offers you the ability to stream at a maximum of 1080p 60fps, provided that your internet speed can handle it. There are no prerequisites for streaming with that level of quality, and YouTube even provides you with some handy guidelines to get to that level. Twitch also has the ability to provide you with that kind of quality, though with one major and very significant difference. With YouTube Gaming, viewers are able to change the quality of the stream as they see it by using a quality setting at the bottom right. All streamers get this, whether they're partnered or not. On Twitch, however, you need to be partnered or hosting a high, consistent level of viewers in order to attain such an option. This means that if you're trying to stream at 1080p 60fps on Twitch, and somebody with a potato for a modem decides to watch you, their experience is going to be severely hindered because you're sending more data than they're able to receive. And it causes a lot of buffering issues on their end, which may make them miss chunks of the stream or just make the entire thing unwatchable. Which leads me into my next point, buffering and loading. Twitch is a live platform at its finest. There is no way for viewers to go back mid-live stream and see what happened 10 minutes ago. YouTube Gaming, however, offers a DVR option which allows users to scroll back sometime and see whatever they may have missed when they went to get their ice cream or their cat was on fire or whatever happened. Both options may cause the viewer with the potato for a modem to lag. However, Twitch will not allow you to have that quality button to help those folks unless you have a decent amount of viewers or your partner, as we stated before. Next up, copyright. The C word, a content creator's worst nightmare. Copyright is meant to protect other people's intellectual property from unfair use, which is a good thing at its core. Twitch will mute a streamer's VODs, that's video on demand, that uses copyrighted music. However, you can still watch the video. The game itself doesn't get removed, it doesn't get hit, nothing like that. Essentially, you can play Nintendo games without Big Daddy N coming over and taking your house. A copyright strike on YouTube is serious business. Three of these things and your channel goes bye-bye. Sometimes a content owner can just take the money that you make from a certain video. However, if you get three of these strikes, you're done, no more channel. YouTube Gaming may suffer from the same Terminator-like copyright system that its humble content creators have come to fear and respect. Say you do a Mario Maker stream on Twitch. The VOD is probably going to remain there for folks to watch without any kind of issue to you as a streamer. On YouTube Gaming, while you may be able to stream the Mario Maker, saving the stream video for people to watch later could result in a copyright strike against your channel. We've already seen some of the major YouTubers get hit with this, even though Nintendo gave them permission to put a video out there. Since YouTube Gaming is aiming to be a one-stop shop, providing both your streams and your videos to your viewers, this could impact much more than your live streaming. That merciless three-strike rule should be feared here. I mean, it could undo your channel. You have to keep in mind that YouTube's copyright system is automated, so even if you have explicit permission from the game developer, you could still be flagged for a copyright hit, and you're gonna have to dispute it. If you make your living as a content creator on YouTube, your entire source of income could be threatened. Which brings me to my next point, income. Can you make a living on Twitch? Yeah. Can you make a living on YouTube? Yeah. Can you make a living on YouTube and YouTube Gaming? Sure. Is it easy? Fuck no, none of these are easy. Twitch has the partnership program that we all know and love. While they have some guidelines for getting partnered, which are pretty outlandish in my opinion, they very clearly state that each partnership is examined on a case-by-case basis. But what do you actually get with a Twitch partnership? Well, for one, you get that sweet quality button that we talked about for Mr. Potato Net. On top of that, you get a subscription button which allows your supporters to be rewarded for their patronage by getting to use custom emotes that you create for them, having a subscriber icon next to their name when they chat on your stream. And they can be spared from ads that you choose to run as a partner streamer. Non-partner streamers on Twitch get none of these benefits. Twitch also has an exclusivity clause, which means that if you are a Twitch partner, you are not allowed to stream anywhere else for profit. Alright, so Twitch has a subscription model which rewards your viewers for their loyalty and allows you to make some money off of your streaming. So what does YouTube Gaming have? If your channel is cleared for ad revenues on YouTube, then you're able to put ads on your stream and run ads during your stream. There's also the fan funding option, which allows people to donate to your channel, but while on Twitch you have a customizable set of panels that can make it look attractive, YouTube Gaming's fan funding is a little bit hidden. It's a little button on the top right of your video. You'd have to tell people that it's there, and asking for donations as a streamer is never a good idea in my opinion. So what's the conclusion to all this? Let's look at the pros and the cons for each service so far. Starting with the pros for YouTube Gaming, you can run high quality streams without being partnered, viewers can DVR your stream in case they miss something, they can rewind it a little bit, and if you're partnered, you can monetize and run ads. The cons to YouTube Gaming are the strict content ID matching, which could very well get you in trouble, no customization whatsoever for your stream page, no subscription model nor benefits for your viewers, such as custom emotes or a little icon or nothing, and very little support for the streamer. Now on to Twitch. The pros here are your customizable streaming page with the panels and all that stuff. Partner streams can offer the subscription model, which encourage people to support you and get benefits for doing so, and you can also run ads during your stream. And content matching extends only to the music you play on stream, not the game itself. Now the cons to Twitch. Non-partner streams will suffer from the no encoding options, that little quality button, unless you get a certain amount of viewers. Getting a partnership is a case-by-case deal, and the standards for getting a partnership are a little absurd. You cannot customize your video-on-demand thumbnails, and the editing interface is a little wonky. In conclusion, if you're streaming for fun and you don't intend on making this a meaningful, sustainable, long-term financial contribution into your life, then YouTube Gaming is the clear winner. You have the higher quality options, which allow your viewers to enjoy a clean stream that they can rewind if they so choose. And if you're careful about content ID matching, you could very well make this your thing. Now, if you're streaming for fun and you find that it's something that you'd like to potentially do for income in the long term, Twitch is the way to go. The subscription rewards encourage your viewers to support you, and you can provide them with a friendly, clean page to enjoy while they watch you play. Having a sub icon next to your name is kind of a status symbol, and providing them with fun emotes that they can spam is enjoyable. If you're willing to put in the hard work and the dedication to get partnered, this is the way to go. Now, one last point here, we have to keep in mind that we're witnessing the infancy of YouTube Gaming. For all we know, they may come out with their own subscription model and benefits for the streamers and the viewers. Only time will tell. As for me though, that concludes this little rant. If you feel that this helped, go ahead and mash that like button, it does help me out. And as for me, I'll see you live on Twitch and on live, I guess, here on my YouTube page. Later!